Well, welcome to Rob's Fix-It Shop, Ice Fishing Edition. Today I have a Vexler ice fishing sonar, I guess. I don't know what else you'd really call it, but it's a fish finder, right? And so it, when you're ice fishing, you can put this little dealie in the water and you'll see how deep it is, but you can also see little blips of fish that are around, right? And I'm not an ice fisherman myself, but it's very popular up here. This is my cousin's fish finder, and he's quite adept at using it, but there's a problem with it, right? And so that's what I'm gonna look at today and see if I can get it up and running for him. It's February right now, so I don't know how much of the ice fishing season is left, but let's just take a look at it. And I think it's gonna be very interesting to figure out how this thing works. So here it is, kind of overhead look. You've got gain. I don't know what this norm AZBL is. And here's the range. I think that's the depth. These things seem to be working. But what happens is you're getting all kinds of false readings. And I'm getting them when I kind of move this wire here. So, I mean, this is the transducer, and you can see that it's most likely a cabling problem right as it's coming in here. And I'm wondering if, you know, it's just there's a bad ground on the receiver, right? Because we can see all kinds of weirdness happening when I just kind of wiggle that. So I screwed up the sound on this part of the video, but I just wanted to say I went to Vexlar, and they have a video that shows how to test these transducers. And what you do is you put it at the edge of a table, and you put it as far up as you can below the table, and then you have a hard surface on the floor. And this is about 3 feet here. And so the speed of sound in air is about three times slower than it is in water. So you can see that it's showing 9 feet here. And so you can clearly see that this transducer is working, right? And I got this transducer from a friend of mine in the neighborhood. I was telling him about this thing I'm fixing, and he's like, oh, I've got one of those. So it's good that I can test it with one that's working. But now let's look at the bad one. So here I have the bad transducer hooked up, and I can see if I just move the cable around just a little bit, you can see that the signal kind of dies out. And so I think that test works pretty good. My suspicion is there's a wiring problem right at the head, right where the wire goes in. But anyways, that's just showing that we can see that it's bad. The signal coming back is bad. And it's interesting, I can feel it pulsing. But I wonder if the ground shield isn't messed up there and the signal coming back is just noisy. I don't know. But you can see you can get a replacement for about $100. I think it's this one here. And I'm going to guess that that's what we're going to have to do. All right. So I thought it'd be fun to kind of look at the signals coming out of this. So I made myself these jumpers here, and I'm going to put them between here and the cable transponder, and we'll take a look at what we're seeing. So okay, I got to be straight with you. I have kind of looked at these before, and the signal going into the transducer is high voltage, so I have a 100 times probe, and let me just set my probe to 100 times. All right, and so I'm going to connect this up to my shield wire, and I kind of mic'd out these values before, or checked out these values, and then I'll connect onto here one of the transducer wires and turn it on. And oh, hold on, let me put the transducer so it's hanging down, kind of in the same configuration as the test we just did. Oh, there we go. So here we're seeing the pulse. So that's the so that's the pulse that we're putting into the transponder. And we can see here it's about 200 kilohertz. Make sure I got that. That's about 200 kilohertz right here. And let me see. And 550 volts peak to peak, right? So that's putting it in quite a bit. And then if I turn it to low power, I think I lost my trigger. At low power, you can see it's all it's really reducing is turning down the volume, turning down the volume on this, on the signal going into the transponder, right? And let's see how wide this is. So it looks like it's pulsing for about 100 microseconds, right? But, so I've kind of looked at this before. I'm kind of cheating. I looked at it quite a bit before, but the signal that's coming back, so let me show you the a calculation I did. So what I did is I just put this kind of spreadsheet together, put the speed of sound in water and the speed of sound in air, and then I figured out the distance here from the transducer to the floor, and then so it should take about 1.92 milliseconds to hit the ground, and then 3.8 milliseconds to hit the ground and come back, right? So that's just taking the speed of sound and saying how far is it, doing a few easy calculations to kind of come up with that number. So after our initial pulse, 3.84 milliseconds after our initial pulse, we should see the response, right? But if we look here, let me move this over. And shrink it a little bit. Right, so the if we have our first, okay, we got that there. And if I go out about, whoops. milliseconds, there's nothing that we can see there, right? But that's because the signal coming back is so small, right? It's in the tens of millivolts. And here, this signal is 500 volts, right? So what I'm gonna do is, so what I need to do, I need to put a probe on the same signal that this is seeing, right? But I wanna clip that signal, I wanna clip it, because if I just tried to hook it up here and turn it way up, it would, the scope won't be able to handle it, right? Because it's going to 500 volts and you're turning it down to look at, you know, 20 millivolts per division, right? And so you need to clip this signal. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a 3-volt Zener diode and just a resistor, and I'm going to hook that up, and what will happen is that, and I'll hook that up to the other probe, and what will happen is that the signal will come through here, and it won't let anything through until about 3 volts, and then when it does go through, it'll just shunt to ground, right? And this resistor will keep the rest of the circuit working. But so it should clip anything above 3 volts, right? And that should allow me with that other probe to kind of look at a much higher or a much lower signal of that response coming back and be able to see that response. So here's my, let me see if I can get that up there. You see that? Yep. So here's my resistor and my Zener diode. I think I used a 10K resistor. And so I'm going to turn this off because, again, it's high voltage. And I'm going to hook my signal up to this side. And I'm using short leads here, which makes it hard to work with, obviously. But because I think the signal is going to be very low, I want to keep my signal, my lead lengths as short as possible. I'm going to take my shield ground over here, hook that up. Right? Okay, so then I want my high voltage probe here, like it was before. And then my ground, I'm just going to ground to that shield ground. And then my other probe, I'm going to go right to the center, right? Okay, so I finally got it all hooked up. So I have the, it's a little hard to see, but the red wire, you can see our signal here. It's 530 volts peak to peak. And then our other signal here is about 4.4 volts peak to peak. So that's pretty low, right? So, but then that, because it's clipping as it comes through that, so if we look at the signal, you can see that it's clipping here. So this is 500 volts and this is 4.4 volts, right? So I'm gonna scrunch that up, and then let's start hunting for that for that response. Go over here. So we should see it right in here somewhere. Let's try turning it up. And I think we're just seeing a tiny bit right there. There it is. Right? So that's our response right there. And if we we have our one cursor here, if we move our other cursor just to the start, we have 3.8 milliseconds, which is what we kind of predicted, which is very cool, I think. Here, I'll put my foot under it and you see it disappear. And let me see if I can. Yeah. Yeah, so I think if we move that into the center, right, and then bring it up. There we can see the actual 200 kilohertz there, and and that's only about 20 millivolts, right? That's a pretty small signal. Anyway, so it took me a little bit to figure out how to get that to where I could see it, but it is very interesting to see how this thing works, how it's pumping out that high voltage. and then it's getting this super small signal back. I don't know. It's got there's some circuit magic that's going on to switch these guys over and then kind of amplify and filter the signal to get the kind of data that we're getting on that screen. So that's pretty cool. So I just thought I'd bring you through that part of the looking at how this guy's working. Well, that's it for Rob's Fix-It Shop, Fish Finder edition. And I learned a lot with this video. I didn't know that much about sonar, and it was kind of fun seeing how this thing worked and figuring out, you know, how to see that echoed signal come back and, how to diagnose a bad sensor, transducer, transponder, whatever you like on these devices. So if you liked it, please hit like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.